अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स स्टूडेंट्स आर टूडेज टॉपिक इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन एंड अ नंबर ऑफ शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन एंड एमसीक्यूज मे बी सिलेक्टेड फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक इंटरेक्शंस इन इकोसिस्टम्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इंटर स्पेसिफिक एंड इंट्रा स्पेसिफिक इंटरेक्शंस। द इंटरेक्शंस between the members of the same species is called intraspecific interactions, while the interactions between the members of different species is called interspecific interaction. This is the difference between intra and interspecific interactions. The first interaction under discussion is competition. Write the importance of competition. Competition helps in maintaining a balance between the available sources and number of individuals of a species. Intraspecific competition is always stronger and more severe than interspecific competition is an important short question as well as MCQ. Next interaction is predation. Define predation. Give examples. Predation is an interaction between two animals of different species or between a plant or an animal. In predation, one organism, the predator, attacks, kills, and feeds on other organisms, the prey. And examples are given below. All carnivore animals are predators. This is an important MCQ. Plants also show competition for space, light, water, and minerals. Next, which plants are carnivorous and live as predators? Certain plants, pitcher plant, sundew, Venus flytrap, etc., are carnivorous and live as predators. Moving towards MCQs. Leaves of plants are modified to capture the prey. The last MCQ is, host can survive without parasite, but parasite can't survive without host. Next, alright students, the first question on this page is, how predation keeps the prey population under check? So as to maintain an ecological balance, predation keeps the prey population under check. Humans benefit from this interaction in the biological control of weeds and pests. In order to control pests in an area, their predators are released there. Next topic is symbiosis. It is also an important interaction. Definition of symbiosis is there. How many types of symbiosis are there? Symbiosis is of three types. First type is parasitism. Define parasitism. It is a type of symbiosis between members of different species in which smaller partner parasite derives food and shelter from body of larger partner host and in turn harms it. The definition of symbiosis and parasitism may be considered as an important MCQ. Differentiate between temporary and permanent parasitism, and here it is a difference between these two types of parasitism. Right, types of parasites. Parasites may be classified as ectoparasite and endoparasite. Define ectoparasite. Ectoparasite live outside the body, that is on the surface of host body, and gets food from there. Examples include mosquitoes, leeches, lice, etc. Moving towards MCQs, leech, beet bug, mosquito are examples of temporary parasites of humans. Others MCQ may be taken from the examples of ectoparasites also. Next definition is of endoparasite. Endoparasite live inside the body of host and get food and shelter. Bacteria, viruses, tapeworm, ascaris, entamoeba, plasmodium, etc. are the examples of endoparasite. students, the examples of endoparasite may also be selected for important MCQs. Next, a very important short question. What is Hostria? Some plants, for example, Cascuta, also called dodder, are parasites on other plants. Parasitic plants grow special types of roots, Hostria, into host body and suck the required nutrients from the vascular tissue of host. This is the definition of Hostria. Next topic is an important interaction, that is mutualism. Define mutualism. In this type of symbiotic interaction, both parents of different species get benefit and neither is harmed. For example, termites eat wood but are not able to digest it. Other examples may also be discussed. Next, moving towards the MCQs. Termites secrete cellulase enzyme to digest the cellulose of wood. The nitrogen fixer bacterium Rhizobium lives in the root nodules of leguminous plants like pea, gram, etc. Alright students, our next interaction is commensalism, and we will discuss the commensalism as an interaction in the next video inshallah. Okay, thank you very much students.